Hello, good morning.
Morning.
Hi, hi. So can I call you Das or Chanchal?
Yes, yes. Are you not audible?
Yeah, you are audible. I can hear you. My name is Radhakrishnan, known as RK.
Okay, okay, Radhakrishnan ji, okay.
Good morning, Dada.
Good morning.
Morning, RK.
Yeah, morning, Vipin.
Just waiting for Dr. Ravi to join and then we can start.
Okay, okay. So, can I have some introduction, Radhakrishnan ji?
Yeah, I'm Anji. Just waiting for Dr. Ravi to come.
Okay, okay.
Then we can start, I think. Otherwise, we'll have to repeat all that.
Okay, okay. No issue.
How is the weather in KL today, Vipin? Here it is overcast today. Yesterday there was, it was very sunny day. Today it looks like it may rain.
Same here. It is overcast. But, I mean, it's been raining on and off. So, the KL weather, you know, rain is not far away at any point of time.
Yeah.
Okay. I am from Mumbai.
Okay. So, you are now in Mumbai or?
Yes. Yesterday, I came to Mumbai from Ahmedabad.
Oh, okay. Which part of Mumbai?
I am near Thane.
Yeah, you are based in which part of Mumbai, Chanjalji?
Thane.
Thane.
Yes.
So right now I am in Kerala. I am from Kerala. I am in Kerala right now.
Okay.
So JB has joined Vipin.
Okay. Okay, so good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
So we welcome Mr. Chanchal Das in this meeting today. He's an innovator. He's an old ONGC person, and he has done a lot of stuff in many fields. Basically, he is a mathematician, but he has developed many other skills while he has been doing a lot for mathematics also. He has launched some books and software. So, I will let him speak for himself. But before I go there, I think Dr. Chanchal, you know me as well. And here are my colleagues, Mr. RK and Dr. Ravi. Who will also introduce themselves. We have all set up companies in different countries, and we have come together to collaborate and work for, providing help and support to the business that we were engaged in for many, many years. Thank you. Over to you, RK.
Okay, good morning, Vipin, and good morning to Chanchal ji and Dr. JB.
Good morning.
Yeah. So my name is Radhakrishnan, but somewhere or other, people call me RK. Even when I was in India, I got this nickname. So I also started my career with ONGC in 1978 in Mumbai. So I was initially I was in the production operations, and I was involved heavily in setting up the Trombay terminal along with Mr. Sadana, Tia Sadana. Then, but my stint in ONGC was very short. I left ONGC after 5 years. So in 83, I went to Middle East and I joined Dubai Petroleum, which was operated by ConocoPhillips. So, and I spent my full life over there. So I started there again in the production operations, and then in 1988 I moved to reservoir engineering. And then I was always in the reservoir engineering department, and 2014 I retired from there. And then one Russian company service provider contacted me, so I joined them as their global reservoir engineering advisor. And then the last 3 years of my profession I spent in KL with Petronas, and that's when I came to know both Ravi and Vipin. And in 2020 I fully retired from, not fully retired, but retired from my professional life with companies and set up my own consultancy firm in Dubai. So I spend most of my life in Dubai. So my son is still working there. So I try to make a start from there in the business. So I have set up a company there in the free zone in Dubai, in consulting, basically subsurface related work. And in the process, I also tied up with Vipin and Ravi because we are all new consultants with a lot of experience. Mm-hmm. But unfortunately, this corona hit, and then we couldn't work as efficiently as it would have been without corona, because people started working from home. So meeting people, going to companies, etc., became very difficult. But in the in the process, what we did is that we managed to have a lot of collaboration agreements with different service providers and companies with a variety of equipment and technology. So then actually Vipin told us about you. You have developed quite a lot of things, software basically, which for simulation, etc. So I think it will be good for us to collaborate, and wherever we can support each other, that's what we are looking forward to. And with corona now subsiding and companies trying to become normal working mode, we look forward to getting some opportunities in the Middle East, as well as I am focused on Middle East, Nigeria, Libya, etc. I have some connections over there. So hopefully things will move and improve with the corona getting a little bit less now. So let's hear from you, Chanchalji, what is your tool, and hopefully it will be something good for the industry, because you have a lot of experience. So let us hear about it, and then hopefully we can promote it for you in Middle East and other locations. Thank you very much.
Okay, good. Good to learn, actually. And Dubai, where are you based? I was there in Dubai Investment Park too.
Oh, I was in, I stayed in Dubai Investment Park 1 for quite some time. So when I was with Dubai Petroleum, actually they provided me accommodation in Jumeirah. So I was in Jumeirah area. Then Dubai Investment Park, I rented one place there, and I was staying next to that Hilton Hotel over there, where Choitram and all are there. Yeah. And then I moved to Karama for some time. Currently, I'm staying in a place close to Sharjah. This area is called Al Nahda. So this is much cheaper now. Since I have retired, there is no regular income. I thought of moving to a little bit cheaper accommodation. So currently I am in Al Nahda. I'm staying with my son, actually. He is also staying there.
So Dr. Ravi, can you start your introduction, please?
Okay. So good morning.
Good morning.
Chanchalji, Bipin and RK.
Yes.
It's a pleasure to have Mr. Chanchal. I am a geophysicist by profession. So I joined Oil India in 1984. I was with Oil India till 2003. Then I spent 5 years in Middle East, in Bahrain. And from 8 to 19, I was with Petronas Malaysia. I am basically a reservoir geophysicist, specialization in the reservoir characterization. So after coming from the Petronas, I have opened a consultancy, GeoPan Global, in Noida. So I'm based in Noida. I'm in India. And we are looking subsurface opportunities, subsurface projects and opportunities in the Indian E&P sector. At the same time, one of our core business area is the innovation. And we are still looking if we can develop or we can establish ourselves in the field of new technology and innovation. So with that aspiration, I welcome your presentation, and we'll be more keen to listen to your innovative ideas. Thank you.
Okay, good. Thank you. And actually, good morning to all of you, and myself, Chanchal Das. I'm basically a mechanical engineer, and I joined ONGC as assistant director reservoir in 1990, and then with mechanical engineering background. that made me unique, actually. What I should say after long days spending as reservoir engineer, because my outlook was many times different from the conventional reservoir engineers or petrophysicist or petroleum engineers. And I was looking the things differently. Many times I had many confrontations also. And many times what I got during my ONGC period, my suggestions that is to some extent upbeat than not normal, benefited many of the wells. Actually, we were first for 13 years I was involved in oil testing, and from oil testing we could do a lot of innovations in the sense some oil after drilling declared dry. With my reservoir studies, I established that it is not dry. We have not tested properly, and if we can test properly, it can produce oil. And it happened when they listened to me like that. And those are the very challenging and good experience. I really see all those things. But my main activity was what I should say started when I was made FPR of Shannon Field. Shannon Field, actually, I joined in Shannon Field around 2005. And that time there was huge controversy around Shannon Polymer Flood Project. Many of the people thought that polymer is not working properly and it was not required. Many people think that polymer flood was not required. We would have got same recovery without polymer also. So similar confusion were there, and there was no solid proof that whatever recovery we achieve, that is due to polymer. There is no, they do simulations, but the XYZ, those are not using simulator. They never understand, they never agree on that whatever simulator is giving, it is giving right result or not. So with that background, I started my journey and I started looking at that, what made that polymer flood, the claim that polymer flood has added 10% extra recovery and it can increase three times what is the normal depletion drive recovery. So that was the starting point, and I started from scratch to understand the whole history I had, because it was completed in 1962, the Shannon was discovered, and we had a lot of data when I was working on that. And in between, there was pilot in 1985, pilot polymer started, then it was extended, then it is extended to whole field. Then, so a lot of data was there, and I started my analysis from scratch. So I thought of yesterday when Vipinji has asked me to present, then where to start and how to start. Then I thought of starting my thoughts, what I was presented in SP 2008 conference at Mumbai. That will be the very good starting point. So I will, I think that paper, I am trying to explain from that paper, then you will get a clarity on what was my approach and how I have done it. Is it good to start there?
Vipinji? Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. So, yes.
Okay. So we are looking towards two parts presentation here. Yes, one is related to the tool that you developed for quick reservoir simulation, which is Excel based. But it can help, let's say, to do a very quick analysis of how things are in a particular setting. The second is about the commingled production injection thing. So, divide your time.
Yes.
Please go ahead. You can choose how much time you want to spend on each of them.
I will not take 15-20 minutes for each.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. So, I am going to share my screen. This is the paper, I think. Can you see my screen?
Yes, yes.
Okay, yes. So this was a polymer flood project, what I was appear then, and my analysis is there. I will, you are all experienced people, so I will not spend much time on this slide. I will give an overview how I have used this data. So, this was Anand Field in India, and the first well 15, it was drilled at the highest peak at the, of the reservoir. There was a oil water contract, but it is at drain down. So this was the at the top of the reservoirs, and but these are the reservoir properties, and you can see here viscosity. This was the water viscosity, this and oil viscosity 20. So huge contrast in viscosities. These 2 points, oil viscosity is 20 and water viscosity nearly only is 0.38. So this was the contrasting thing, and with that these are the histories. And the issue is that after few months, this oil, though structurally higher position, that oil started cutting water. So this was the water in 1985, the water cut percentage I have given that all. So these are the water cut, you can see all wells, including that 15, which is in a structurally higher position. All these things was together. So initially we started a pilot polymer, this, but I don't think that it was much effective because one injector and four producer. And I think we should not say that it was very successful because the duration and the quantity of fluid injected, that my analysis tell it was little effect on those things. But subsequently, it was extended in 4 injector and this small area. And then extended this later commercial scheme, expanded pilot, all these things. And this was the chase water. And this is the production and injection level. You can see that water cut blue is water cut and oil production. How this frequently water cut was going more than oil production. So this is the graphically I have shown that which period what was happened and why it has happened. You see here water cut increase more and oil production decrease tremendously. Then we have taken some corrective measures, and from that actually we have drilled 1-2 wells which was giving fresh oil initially. So it is not due to that initially due to polymer injection. It is that oil production increase maybe due to the addition of new oils. But subsequently you can see that the rate of water production, it was flattened. This is the main effect of polymer flood. But unless until I tell that how it has helped in oil production, from this data it is not very clear that the polymer how affected. So that was the study. You can see here the number of oils and oil production. Though we increased number of oils, production was coming down. But here actually we get benefit of that oil production was with less water cut. So this was the initial observation when first prediction was that if we go for depletion drive recovery, it will cut 40% we will recover. Then if we go for water flood, it will be 15%. And actually, polymer flood recovery was 24% in 2007 and envisaged in 2020, which is 36, but it has not 36, we could not achieve in by 2020, but it is around 28-29. And this was the starting point of my analysis. While I told that I have used my Excel knowledge and classical reservoir engineering, first I tried to understand the effect of aquifer. So this is the curve we generated with Havrena Ode material balance equation, and it is showing that it is having influenced by water cut, huge aquifer water. So this is the starting point. The field is producing from influenced by active aquifer. So with that, this is the PBT. From PBT we have analyzed. This is the PBT data, and if we use this PBT data with this bubble point pressures and all those things we take consideration, then this will be the recovery in depletion mode. You can see that it will in depletion mode it will recover only 2%, 3%, like that depletion drive performance of Shannon oil. And all this calculation has been done with Excel calculations. And here you see, this is was the expected recovery depletion drive curve. This black one should be, but actual field pressure has not decreased. This is another indication that this reservoir is getting influenced by aquifer. So it is not producing under depletion drive. That is why another means litmus test, what we say intuitively, but we cannot show it. But this data shows that yes, it is influenced by aquifer. So my calculation went on. What was the oil viscosity effect? So here I have started calculating this water cut and oil recovery, how it is affects relative permeability is like that, and fractional flow. If with this relative permeability, this will be the fractional flow with different mobility ratios. You can see here, and this is the mobility ratio. If it is 4, these are the calculations we made all in my things, and then we have plotted that. Cumulative production with oil recovery. We have shown you the cumulative production with time, but here we have used this to show that cumulative recovery up to 1992 with water cut. So you can see that water cut has increasing tremendously here during 10 or 15%. This is the thing. If you would have continued with water flooding, then we would have recovered this 15% what I have shown there. So these are the things where there is no doubt, because we know that what effect affecting the recovery, how water cut is increasing. So these are the handy calculations, not that a lot of things in actual IMX, and I started STAR in CMG for polymer flooding. There you can change a small, any parameter and you get some figure as you wish. But here you know that what is the data you have given and what is the effect here. So 15% recovery would have been achieved, and that is proved actually by this data. If water cut recovery cannot go, why it is not go beyond 15%? So Then this is the viscosity effect of mobility ratio on the movement of fractional flow. So if it is a favorable mobility ratio, then the how this fractional flow curve behaves, and based on that, how this recovery acts, all these things in correlating. These are the simulators we have done in our Excel. And now this was the case in 1993, and then subsequently we have plotted, and you can see this how this water cut at when I calculated this how water cut curve has flattened. So this is the additional recovery. Otherwise it have followed this path. Now it is following this path. So this is the additional gain. We are two benefits we are getting. We are handling less water and we are recovering more oil, which is both economically huge impact on any oil production. And this is the my calculation and simulation. And from that you can see that we can what is the additional oil we receive here. So this simulator we have done in our Excel, and this is one part of my work. And this part, when any reservoir engineers work on any field, they can easily apply these techniques, because this is the thing what happens actually in oil field. First, you can see that whether this is a depletion drive reservoir or it is a closed boundary reservoir or not. If it is not, then how, if it is there aquifer, then how, what is the effect of this aquifer on reservoir? How much you can start calculating on that? Then you can play with that, which parameters are affecting the flow, and accordingly you can choose. If some field is producing in depletion drive, their behavior will entirely different than the field which is producing under tremendous mobility contrast ratio. So all these things can be modeled, and you can handle this easily with this simple. It takes you used all the classical theories, so there is no established theories, and there will be no ambiguity of choosing your reservoir data and all these things. So this is for Sanand field, whatever I have done. This was a these are the gain, how we can calculate. So any question from this? Calculations has been done in Excel. Yes.
Okay, any questions?
No question per se, but I think, Vipin and Devi, we had been talking about something like this. I think this is very good work done by Chanjal ji. Means this is basically going back to the basics. Like, you are not looking at very hi-fi things and simulation with so much of changes and all. No, very quick look analysis. Means this might take him like 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Whereas if it has to be done with a simulation study, it may be 6 months work. So I think this is very good. And this is what actually we had been talking about, I think, these things, you know, like simple equations, calculations using Excel, etc., which most of the employees in the organization are aware of. But if you put a petrol or a CGM or CMG, any sort of simulation, it will need a lot of time for people to understand and learn. So I will say thank you, Chanjal ji. You have done a great job, and I think this is a great tool in my view.
Yes, what I felt that when I was using, I learned Eclipse, I learned the CMG, IMAX, and then STARS and all those things. And I was first creating that model, 3D model, that itself take time, that is controversial, then putting the sales, putting the parameters on that, and all those things combined, there are a lot of effects. But reservoir engineering deals with this part. Here, there is no effect of geology, geophysics, and all other things. We clearly demonstrate what is the effect on reservoir and for what properties, whether it is fluid property or rock property. Rock property is taken care of this relative permeability. Fluid property is viscosity, bubble point, the depletion modes, and all those things are taken care of here. All these things, and very easily we can pinpoint that yes, this parameter is affecting the performance of this field.
No, definitely this is not a replacement to simulation study or whatever it is, but this is a quick look analysis of the field. No, really quick, you can understand what are the factors influencing the performance of the reservoir, where should I focus, and this is a great tool to do that. No, we are, this is not a replacement to simulation, we agree to that, but
can you on your video so that I can see you.
Okay. Yeah, I thought sometimes, you know, the video sometimes takes
because,
on a
because
lot of...
Because actually, this work can be endorsed by an expert only. They will understand that what is the importance of basics. Many people think, oh, this is Excel, what they will do in Excel, what they will do in classical thoughts. They want that star simulation or all those things there. But the importance of these basics and the Excel tool, handy tool, that gravity of it can means understand by an expert only.
No, means to me it's a great tool, means because thank we are you. All comfortable using Excel, and these are the basic engineering equations that we use in reservoir engineering to understand how the field is behaving, how the wells are behaving, what are the main things which is influencing. Now in this case, actually it is the aquifer, as you said. So probably if they would have developed this field with a different in a different scenario, the recovery would have been much better also. Like I think maybe this would have been developed with drilling in the down deep first, then coming up along with the water cut development, rather than drilling all the way at the top, and you create a pressure sink there, which allows this strong aquifer to bring in a lot of water to the upper part of the reservoir at the early stage. So, that is the information that you get from this type of quick study. So, this is a quick look, quick study, and I really appreciate this type of work. And me, Vipin, and we were talking about these sort of tools, no? Like this is what we need, rather than, I know the modern guys, like the young engineers, they want to come and see all these hi-fi things in the simulation modules and put things there without understanding what they are doing and come up with some recommendations, and you drill wells, you make a lot of mistakes and spend a lot of money for the company. So I'm in support of this type. Yeah, I'm in support of this type of tools, actually.
Thank you. Actually, I faced also same thing. I initially was very passionate about Eclipse. So when I started learning this Eclipse, I was very happy. And because it is a very difficult tool actually to learn. Even then, I was not that happy with that. Then I started IMEX, and then I started this STAR for chemical flooding. And then I realized something, a simple thing is required, because I was not getting the effect. This is the controversy started with the aquifer, because without aquifer also we can get same performance, you know.
Mm.
Without aquifer also, if we can manipulate that.
Correct, yeah. You can modify a lot of parameters in the simulation model.
It's a relative permeability curve, no? We can play with relative permeability curve, and we can match that history.
Yes.
And that will never actually reflect that behavior, actual behavior of the field. So there was the main problem was starting. Because just chemical engineers, those are involved in polymer flooding, they are not expert in simulation. And the simulation team was not expert in this chemical process. So anyhow, after I combined this, I was very happy. And I, when I presented this in Mumbai, you know, it was one of the hall was getting packed to listen to my lecture there. I was very happy that the hall was overflowing. In Mumbai SP conference.
Okay, Dada.
Yes.
Would it be possible to show, give a sort of demo on the actual Excel where you do this, so that, that we can.
That I request you to have a different time.
Okay. So we can arrange a different meeting for that. Yes. So now I think with RK and myself both in favor of this approach, we are yet to hear from Dr. Ravi, but he's muted. Maybe he can speak later. Let us go into the part two of this presentation today.
Okay. So I am presenting from my Facebook page.
Oh, okay.
So this is the, this I presented in Egypt in, I think, 2013. I was presenting not multiple gene completion. Main focus was that how trees can be used for development of oil field technologies. This is innovation tool from that perspective I presented, but how I have used these trees in development of my multiple gene completion that I have presented here. So you can see this is the cross flow. Cross flow is a generic problem in oil field. You know, whenever there are multiple reservoirs and complete is together, then high pressure reservoir flows to the low pressure reservoirs and all those things happens. So cross flow is a generic problem from the early times from in the oil industry, and many efforts are there to produce that reservoir without cross flow. So these are the generic technique what we follow. This sequential production means we produce from one layer, keeping other isolated with bridge plug, and then after upper zone exhausted, then we drill the bridge plug and complete the second object like that. We complete it, and otherwise we go for separate wells, multiple tubing, or commingle and multilateral. These are the things, and you know, or the advantage, disadvantage of all those things. So I was thinking that how to avoid cross flow, and when I analyzed all those things, these things, then simply we can think that what actually we want to do. Here we want to produce separately. So separate is the problem. I required some tools to separate the reservoirs. So with that simple objective, it can be done in many ways. I have removed all those methods from my mind. I don't know how we can separate. All this effort is for separation. So here you can see multiple zone we are separating. Here also we are separating. So this also we are separating. So how we can be done? So all these studies actually are trees related. Trees tells us how we can, this is inverted system question here. So you start single well, combing well. You can start from anywhere. So what is the advantage, disadvantage? You can see here. Useful function, UF means useful function, symbol is that UF requires, then this is a arrow,
like that, and useful function which we want to eliminate, that is arrowed like that, and useful function red arrow is caused harmful function. When you do something, this is a contradiction any in life. When you try to do something better, some other parameters get negatively affected. This is called contradiction. So our objective is to remove the contradiction. So here also, when we go for simultaneous production, then it cross flow. Then you, when you try to isolate and produce sequentially, then what happens? You loss NPV. So similar thing, every action you do, there is a contradiction. One parameter affects negatively. So how to do there? It is means this graphically shown here. I'm not going to explain these details, but with this we can this DAS well what I have developed can eliminate cross flow and multiple layers can be produced together. So here I have depicted graphically. Here we have done multiple tubing. What I was we are doing multiple tubing here. So you can see that we wanted to isolate each layer and we put a packer in between. And here it is simple. It is complex left side and middle one is the simple. Here we have opened all the layers together. So here we are eliminating cross flow, but here we are adding cross flow. So here when we are eliminating cross flow, we are adding complexity. And here when we are removing complexity, we are adding cross flow. So these are the contradictory problems with our existing system. So how I have done here, it is simple and no cross flow. You can see I have isolated the zones here. And this is my tool. I have isolated the intervals and we set our packers here conventional way. We set our packers in tubing, with tubing. So our system becomes, what I should say, constrained. They are, because you have to set whatever you have to do, you have to do with this tubing and tubing flexibility lost. Here I am not doing these packers. I am adding these packers in casing and isolating the perforation intervals. And then we are putting a valve, which is my innovation, this valve, because we face problem with space, because within these small tools, we have to accommodate all these things. So here we cannot put conventional valves. So this is the valves, and we Schlumberger smart oil and intelligent oil, they use umbilical things in electrical connections or hydraulic to operate these valves. They have done something like that, but here it operates at its own. No external energy is required to operate this. So this is simple and no cross flow. This is my tool. Now one Dubai company at Dubai Investment Park, they have acquired this technology and they have manufactured and they are now supplying it globally. So I am a partner. They are giving loyalty to me and this tool they have acquired. Now we will be starting one ONGC oil to deploy it there. So in nutshell, this is the my multiple zone completion tool. Very simple, very cheap, and without cross flow, you can produce even n number of zones. N can be 10, 5, any numbers. And at the same time, there will be no cross flow, and it will be very simple to use. So this is my second work. And actually, I had a lot of other things in mind to work with for improving oil field technologies, but I am not getting proper support for financially and means individually, it is very difficult. Though I have a company, but funding is required. All my savings I have already spent with my research, but there are 2-3 very good ideas about using new technique for improving oil field production and use of oil field whatever. Suppose you, when we drill a hole and we get a huge aquifer without any oil, and we immediately abandon it. But there are many, many. We can use it in many way, other ways, rather than, because when we drill, then the expenditure are already incurred. So we get that aquifer, and that aquifer can be used for many other purposes. What I mean to say, but there some studies is required. So lot of ideas are there. We can work on those new ideas also.
So this technology, Chanjalji, this isolation technology. So you said these valves work based on differential pressure, or
yes.
How
yes.
do they work? And then, like, how do you know that particular sections are producing, because they are behind the tubing? So the typical normal PLTs and things like that won't work, right?
No. Here you see, all the work you can do, what we require to be done in individual reservoirs. And this is not conventional valves what we use. So, and this is our patent, actually. This is our patented technology, but we are thinking to go without patent, and we try to maintain as a trade secret. So this valve, actually, the principle of this valve actually depends on differential pressure of reservoir and wellbore.
And wellbore, yeah.
Yeah. So you cannot get uniform delta P. The delta P depends on the wellbore pressure and the reservoirs. So
yeah, but my point is now, looking at this third diagram where symbol no cross flow, you don't have any packer or anything in between those three layers. So ultimately, the pressure in the casing, it is not the tubing, in the casing will equalize, right? When you are producing from all these three layers, the pressure will be same in the casing. So the valves will be sensing the same pressure in the casing, rather, maybe slight difference because of the height difference. So how
means height difference, if you normalize height difference in commingle also, we cannot maintain, means if you adjust the height, then you can say it is uniform pressure. You can maintain only one pressure in oil bore. You cannot maintain multiple pressure in oil bore.
Correct. So that's my point. So then if you are upper zone.
That many people don't understand also. They think that depending on different reservoirs, oil bore pressure is different. No, oil bore is one pressure. And reservoir can have different pressure, and depending on that, through reservoir pressure and oil bore pressure, the delta P is determined. So some delta P will be more, some delta P will be less, and some delta P may be negative. So in negative case, what happens here, immediately cross flow starts. But in my case, if it is negative, that cross flow, it will not take, it will not give.
Okay. Now I understood your point.
That is the beauty of this technology. You can practice healthy reservoir management strategies.
Okay, so it is like this is a check valve which will stop cross flow from the high pressure reservoir into the low pressure, because it will block that valve will close. It is not that you will not get anything out. Okay, that point I got. Okay. Understood. All right. Okay.
Actually, we require in commingled flow, this is the problem. Mm-hmm. Because when you produce at a low pressure, both produces in commingled flow. But problem is that when one pressure goes up, means if you shut in or something, then immediately cross flow starts. So this sort of thing will not happen in my case. Means one reservoir
neighbor can influence other reservoir.
So, Dada, I mean, yes. One question that I have is, I mean, if you look at the, you know, the width of the or length of the green
part,
which is actually the isolating all the perforations,
yes.
And then the small portion, which is the valve, which is the red thing.
This is actually, I'm telling you, practical size. This can be lowered as low as 5.5-inch casing, first.
So, actually, hear me out first.
I am explaining. I am explaining your point.
My question is more related to PI. Would there be a deterioration of the PI just because we are now allowing a very small path for the reservoir fluid to come out?
No. It's a small path, not something. I am not restricting anywhere. That is the beauty of these things. PI will not get affected with my valves, first thing. And these multiple zones can be used in 5.5-inch. Actually, my first motivation was that, you know, I stay in Ahmedabad, Mehsana, Tambe, Ankleshwar. All these major fields are at a depth of 1400 to 2000 meters. And majority of that wells use all are multi-layered, and majority of the wells we deal with 5.5-inch casing. So this casing can be as low as 5-inch casing without reducing the tubing size. Tubing you can use 2, 7, 8 or 3.5-inch as usual we use in 5.5-inch. So this is the thing. And I have taken care of BPG, all these things. So micro level, we can discuss all those things.
It is only based upon what you are seeing in the diagram. So I'm just trying to clear my doubt.
No, that I am telling, it is not affecting PI in any way.
Okay.
PI, these valves, you can increase, decrease the port size as you require. Port size is not restrict your flow. PI flow is dependent on PI, and PI we can adjust this valve before setting as much fluid. Means you can as I was calculating here, our fields is very low productivity fields as compared to Middle East fields where you produce 10,000, 20,000 barrels per well. And here we struggle with 5 to 50 barrels or 100 barrels. So, but I have taken care of this. These valve ports can be increased, decreased as per requirement. Predefined, we can put a range that it can operate with that much production.
Okay, Dada, okay. Here is the question.
Yes.
Let us say if we were to reverse the process, that means we try to deploy the similar kind of stuff in injector, and we try to restrict a higher amount of injection in a certain particular reservoir.
Actually, I see you see all these effects. No, what? Why I am doing it? It goes to the reservoir engineering part. I am not thinking of deploying this for production engineering. I know that what is required to be done for IUR, UR, and for that we require more injector, more producer, and we cannot go on abruptly go on drilling wells for injector and producer. So my main objective is using this technology for IUR, UR, and injectors. So that without increasing the number of wells drilled in a field, we can use injector and producer with less number of wells and recover maximum oil. That is my behind my heart, actually. But nobody thinks. They think I am doing something production engineering job. No. I know that what IUR process is suitable for this field, but we cannot deploy those IUR process because of cost, high cost. So I am trying to reduce by this type of technology, I am trying to reduce this implementation cost of the IUR process. Mm-hmm. And my technology I am have, this is, it means it is an integrated approach, you can say, to deploy in a field for maximum or optimum recovery.
So Chanchal ji, Vipin, can I ask one question?
You finish? Yeah, please go ahead. Yeah. Please go.
Okay. Chanchal ji, so these valves, you have, can we install them on already completed wells, or these are to be done while?
It is. We have to deploy a workover. You have to take out the completion, patient completion, and you can go on installing this. No, okay. You can do that.
Okay.
And tool is ready at Dubai Dubai Investment Park. Our office is there.
Okay.
So immediately, if you order something, we can immediately act on that.
I will definitely go and try to visit them when I go back to Dubai, maybe next month or so.
I should not share it with whatever study I have done for this ONGC well, where we will be installing it. This is a two-zone reservoir, and all the studies with basic data to oil completion, that report I have submitted. Now ONGC has to take a decision to do that. So, that was very good document for understanding that. But these two papers I can share, because this is in public domain. This is available in my website also. Also there, but it is available in my Facebook page also.
Okay.
And today I will upload it in my LinkedIn page also, so that you can see it.
Yeah.
Okay, Dada. So that would be great. Let us have a look at the papers, and maybe the presentations can be tailored to project. What can be the ideas for IOR, EOR improvement if we pursue certain ideas, right? So let us say if this is the seed idea, then how this can help to transform the IOR, EOR strategies that companies are working with. Because I know that you have already have a arrangement with the one company for this, but essentially that is only for this particular patent, right? But when we talk about how this can become a transformative agent for IOR, EOR strategies, that could be something that you can share with other companies as well or not?
You see, my expertise in IOR, EOR, you have seen in Shannon presentation, you have seen that I am working on IOR, EOR there. Am I audible?
Yes.
So my expertise in IOR, EOR, and this multiple gene completion is a tool I have developed for implementing that ideas.
Yeah.
So I am not a production engineering angle I am working. IUR is my basic domain. What technique can face you maximum recovery? I am expert on that. So that part is my own. That is not related to thing. Only thing I have given my oil, this technology to them for license for this technology. So they can manufacture, they can distribute. I am not going to compete for this technology with them. So other than that, my intellectual powers is mine.
but I think Vipin was asking this question probably to understand how, Chanchalji, how can we collaborate with you, like in promoting your stuff in other locations, and like even the valve technology means we may have to approach the DIP guys, but how can we collaborate with you? What sort of arrangement, if you are interested in working together?
If if you are really interested, because first thing is that these ideas are primarily looks upbeat. First problem I faced that I am reserve engineer and I am doing some production engineering job. So people was apprehension on that, why you are doing production engineer job. They never listen to me properly as you are doing now. So I am not doing production engineering job. I am doing something which is required for IORUR.
Correct.
Because implementation, I cannot go with the existing conventional completion process. We cannot implement many of the known IORUR.
Yes.
So what we can do? So I have seen that our reservoirs are multi-layered. So we can take advantage of that and we can use IORUR.
Yeah,
actually, I am an IOR reservoir engineer.
Yeah, you are trying to optimize the production. Actually, that's so you have identified this technology to optimize production, because this is a complex thing. When we have multiple zones all completed at the same time, there is cross flow. When wherever the pressure, the reservoir with less pressure will try to take the pressure, the flow from the high pressure zones. So you found a solution to that. So it is not the production engineering. It is improving the recovery and optimizing the production. That's what you are doing. So I think that part is really understandable.
In that way I am open to join you, because somebody has to endorse that yes, Tenthelas is in right direction, because I got more opposition than acceptance till date. And if you feel that it is good ideas and good can benefit oil industry, I can join with you also. No.
I think it's
completion technology. Completion technology will be supplied by them.
Yes,
they will be doing everything. But I can propose that this can be helpful. I can go for studies on that. I can give the realistic calculations that if you apply, how it will benefit your production, increase your production, how water cut can be reduced, how cross flow can be eliminated, all these things I can go for it.
Yes, yeah, that part is still there, no? Because only by having that check valve, things are not going to be, you have to do first. No?
Actually, that's why we are not going for patent also. Patent, I have not insisting on that patent, because I know that this is know-how is more required than the patent. And that will be understandable. Those are already budding engineers never understand this.
I think there has to be a study before you install these valves in the reservoir. Yes. So that study part we still can support the client, and we can try to promote this technology or sell this tool or these valves to the companies having commingled production. This is a simple technology, and we can do the study. We select and we manufacture the valves and install it for you. So I think that that's okay. But I think what I am talking about is that now myself, Vipin, and Devi, we are working together as one collaborative unit. So maybe you can have some sort of an agreement. I don't think you need to have with all of us. Maybe Vipin brought you to us. So maybe you can have an agreement with Vipin, and we will try to promote you. I can talk to the companies in the Middle East. Vipin can talk to in Southeast Asia. We can help you with the Indian. So I see some value in this type of Qpiluk tools. In fact, I had this idea of having something like this for recovery factor development, but no, my skills in Excel are not that great as yours, and you already developed a tool, and maybe we can try to give some feedback or something when we really look at the tool, which we said we will have another meeting for that, and maybe give some our views or feedback, and maybe we can improve together that tool and try to probably sell it as a tool to the companies and make money out of it, rather than using it only for analysis purpose. We can give some licenses and sell it to the companies. You can create a licensing package that can be done. So this is my view about what you have presented. I liked all the ideas and concepts that you have done. These are the basic things, and we don't want hi-fi at this point in time. With this basic, we can do a lot of things, and I'm appreciative of that. Thank you very much for the great tools and good presentation.
Thank you, and I'll be happy if you can share your contact ideas so that we can have interaction in future also.
Sure, I probably can share all our IDs, email IDs and contact numbers to you. Let's work together. It's good. Yeah. Okay.
I'm open for joining any consortium, because I know that individually it is very difficult to do anything.
Correct. Yeah. Since it is better, we have many heads working together, no? And with such good tools available, I think if we work together, there will be more opportunities coming our way. Okay,
Vipin. Dr. Ravi, would you like to add anything?
No, I think it's a very good presentation. I had a question from Chanchal on the first presentation. So what I understand that the water cut in the field was because of the large mobility contrast. Am I right?
I mean,
in the first presentation, you saw that all the wells were giving high water cut. And
yes, I can show you that. Can you see my
yes,
slides?
Yes. Yeah. So, the map where you showed that all the wells are producing water. Yeah, here. No.
Yeah.
So
here is a well with water cuts.
Yeah, even higher wells, and all the wells are producing high water cut. So yes. Is it because of the large mobility contrast and large effect of aquifer? That's what you wanted to bring it out. And your effort was to reduce the mobility contrast. Huh? Am I right or I'm wrong? That's what I'm not.
I could not listen you properly, but trying to explain is that these wells are started cutting water soon after completion. But what was the reason of this water coming? It is coming from this aquifer or not? That was one of the issues. And that is why it is coming. So we established that it is coming from aquifer first thing, and it is coming due to high mobility ratio.
Yes. I agree. So all your effort to using chemical was to reduce that mobility contrast. Huh?
Yeah, we polymer plant, we improved that mobility ratio. Means you can make near one, and it will be helpful.
And I think your analytic approach is quite interesting. And as RK said, and RK and Bipin, they are the expert in this field. So taking some ideas, we can move ahead.
The ideas are available in the industry, but no, we try also isolation to calculate this water cut, but I have made a systematic way of calculating that. It is available, formulas is available, everybody read it, but there is no handy tool to calculate like that. And I have calculated all the aspects. From the initial stage, actually, when I present that actual simulation package, what that starts with the fluid properties of the reservoir, how the fluid property is taken care, all aspect. Then when it starts producing, then how pressure drops and how all the fluid properties get affected and what happens when it is above bubble point. What happens when it goes below bubble point? All these things are in calculation. And if there is a aquifer, then how calculation goes on when there is no aquifer, that how the calculation with in a small package, but all calculations are there. You can clearly understand. Anyone can understand that.
Great.
Okay.
Well, thank you again for the very interactive and very nice presentation. Thank you.
Okay. So, thank you, Dada, for sharing your ideas and thoughts with us. Maybe it may be a good idea for you to come forward with how you would like this association with us to help you as well as us. We are interested in both the things. So in the way that we think is that we are in touch with many companies to offer services which range from subsurface studies to any other aspects if it is feasible, but our main focus is on subsurface related studies. And these tools can be very, very helpful, both for the studies as well as, if possible, if you want them to be marketed, then we can think about how to convert them into a marketable, let's say, form. So for example, currently we are also talking about many Excel-based reservoir engineering calculation tools to be converted into a web form that can be marketed as an application. The second part, where there is already arrangement with a Dubai company, we can talk about advancing the technology and using your partners as the vendors. So think about it. In the next meeting, which you let me know when you want to schedule it, we would like to have a demo on the actual simulator which you have developed.
Okay. For the same sake, I am telling you that all the calculation, this is the simulator part I am telling, but all the parameters which is involved in reservoir engineering, no, everything I have Excel calculation sheet for everything. So if you want that Excel-based calculations, you are interested, everything is ready with me. So you need not start from scratch. You can already it is there. You can package it and you can go for it. So all the things are ready with me. And if you give Chanchal Das, I have 7 lectures on reservoir engineering. 7 lectures. And you can see that that lectures I prepared with my interns, which is in ONGC now as a reservoir engineer. He was with me, and we have developed lot 7 classical reservoir engineering lectures with calculations. All these not simple lectures; it is calculation based on Excel calculation. So these videos are there. If you want, you can get it. It is available in internet, and huge people visit on that. And my papers, I think it has downloaded more than 1,000 times. This Sanand paper, huge. Every month, 2-3 downloads are there in Open Petro. And I think they are costing this $25 per paper for outsiders. So many things happens, but I am open with you, joining with you. But I am a researcher. I my main thought is doing something, and you know, a lot of things I am doing in mathematics also. And at the same time, I am just finished the studies of ONGC oil, where we will be putting our technology. So a lot of things I am doing, and if you can suggest how I can be associated with this, except that multi-gen completion, tool will be theirs. We can supply it, we can take them from them, but otherwise intellectual part, anything I am open to join with you.
Okay, good. So on that note, I think if there are no other questions, suggestions, anything somebody want to share, I think we can close it today.
Yeah, I think I have no more questions. Once again, thank you, Chanchal Das, for your innovative, very good concepts. Look forward to working with you. It's very interesting, actually. So thank you very much once again.
Okay.
Okay, Dada.
Okay.
Enjoy your stay in Bombay.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
So my Chanchalji, what is your email ID? I can share my email and details to you.
This is I have written here.
I cannot see. Let me check. Chat. Where did you write in the chat or?
Can you chat.
I cannot see there. Okay, let me put it here in the chat.
CDA001 at gmail.com.
Okay. So I will send you a note and my contact details, I will put it there.
Okay.
Thank you very much again. Yeah.
Okay. So I'm closing the meeting, huh?
Yes, yeah. You can close. Yeah.